This video is the launching point of one wild ride. Posted to the Ring subreddit, Midship92 explains that his neighbor messaged, asking him to check on his wife who was home alone because someone was trying to get inside. After going to check and finding no one, this friendly neighbor went back home, only to find this Ring video footage had been sent to him. The clip shows what the man just missed, a shirtless creep crawling up the front steps of the home, hiding his face away before trying the door in an attempt to break in. The man then lets himself down the steps and walks off, the Redditor adds in the comments. After doing this to several houses and evading police, he was finally caught. Finding the man was quite an ordeal. The Redditor elaborates further, explaining that during the police search, the suspect kept disappearing only to be seen again minutes later, after trying to catch the guy for nearly an hour, only for him to vanish into thin air. The police abandoned the search. Left to his own devices, the man again tried to get in through another neighbor's back door, but the Redditor saw him from his deck. He chased the man into another neighbor's crawl space and stood guard there until the police returned. Thankfully, the wild goose chase led to the wild goose being caught. A ghost hunter named Zaphod Bebley Brox is at the Hill House Manor in Gainesville, Texas, when they get activity on their equipment. The rules of communication are one blink for yes and two blinks for no, but this spirit presses no many times over when asked if it is an older man.
Are you the male that just came back in here?
No, it's a little girl.
His partner thinks it must be one of the two children spirits known to roam this floor, and when they ask if it wants to play, first he uses the equipment to say no, and then he uses its actual voice. It even answers like a child, waiting until the adult says no before repeating him in a small sad voice.
Are you the little girl? Would you like to play jets? Can you say yes or no? Huh? No?
Judging by how she is in no mood to play, I'd say something bad must have happened to them. Something that's keeping them trapped with no release forever. When you're driving home exhausted at the end of the long day, stay conscious and keep your eyes peeled. You might just see this. This supernatural clip was posted in April of 2020, claiming it's a real sighting on a haunted roadside. So let's take a look and see for ourselves. The clip shows someone driving down a dirt road in the near darkness. As they turn a corner, a dark figure barely visible can be seen crossing the path. On closer inspection, the figure looks long-limbed and big-eyed with a strangely shaped skull. It crosses slowly before sitting down at the side of the road. If human, what is this strange behavior? If not, any theories as to what this creature might be? Whether paranormal or some earthly figure, running into this near dusk might be enough to end your life. Here's another ninja cat caught on tape trying to capture a ghost. Daryl Zan published this video in 2012 with the description, "Just a little video of my buddy taping his possessed cat. Also has a ghost orb flash by. The cat starts up in the corner of the door frame, next to the ceiling. She is looking all over, looking towards the ceiling, and balanced between two door frames, just as one of the cat owners says, 'What's she going to do?' A blue streak, the orb in question, flies across the camera lens from the upper right of the screen to the lower left. The man who's filming notices it and says it was weird."
What's she gonna do?
Now that was weird.
But his partner didn't see it. Did the couple's cat sense the ghost in the room? Is that why he'd ninja his way to the top of the door frames? It's more than possible. However, some skeptics in the comments section say that the cat is acting perfectly normal and that the orb looks like a paper airplane. What do you think? This footage comes from India, where a woman is seen cleaning up at a sink. Suddenly, a dark figure appears behind her and gives her a hard shove from behind. She turns around only to find the room empty and hurries away. Smoke wafted through the Yellow Line train on January 12, 2015. While it filled the train, commuters waited over 35 minutes for help to escape. The cause is believed to have been an electrical issue in the tunnel. When the issue occurred, it forced commuters on the platform to evacuate. That's when train 302 pulled towards the platform and took off again. But it was so thick the train operator was blinded. He pulled to a stop in the tunnel. The train's fans were pulling smoke inside, and firefighters were only dispatched when they received a 911 call about 7 minutes later. Meanwhile, the passengers on the train could barely breathe and many got down on the floor. In the raw video of the train, you can see just how bad it is inside the wagon, and you can hear people cough. While most lie or squat on the floor, over the intercom they are told to remain calm and not to open the doors. Some called 911 to describe where the train was located so that rescuers could be sent down. Out of the 380 people who were evacuated from the train, 86 were treated, 9 were treated outside the station, and 1 passed away. A YouTuber named Nerdy Gamer records someone standing outside of his San Antonio home in a clown outfit with a bright red balloon. He opens the door and the two share a tense stare down before exchanging words. The stranger does not respond to warnings or even flat-out threats. However, they do shuffle around for a bit each time after he speaks, which shows that they are at least contemplating what he says.
Creeping right there by my driveway, just staring there. He's been there for about 15 minutes. Yeah, you need to leave, yo. I already caught the cops. Yo, you need to leave. I'm being dead serious. I will you.
Finally, he grows tired of the one-sided exchange and waits for police. No follow-up was recorded after this part. So was this a skit, or did a silent clown really come bother a YouTuber at his own home? The University of Texas once lost 100 human brains. The brains, which were acquired in the 80s for scientific research, sat in jars of formaldehyde in the basement for over 30 years. Decades later, the school decides to move them to a different part of campus, only to find most of them were missing. What's even more bizarre is that all of these brains were donated from an old Texas asylum. Among them was the brain of Charles Whitman, who in 1966 ended the lives of a dozen university students. After taking aim from a tower, no one knows what happened to them for sure, but according to rumors, students were taking them every year to use as props for Halloween parties. The main point is that the minds of over 100 inmates have gone missing, and no one knows what is currently being done with them. On September 24th, 2016, Corey McKeague went missing around the area of Bury St. Edmunds in Suffolk, England. The CCTV footage published in October of 2016 to YouTube by #FindCorey shows the serviceman's last known movements. From one angle, he is seen somewhere meandering down the road, not walking a straight line. He passes two men and appears to drop something on the ground, which he quickly picks up before continuing on. Another camera view shows him walking casually around a corner with his hands in his pockets. The town center footage shows McKeague enter a cul-de-sac with wheelie bins in it. This is where he was last seen. His mobile phone was tracked from this cul-de-sac to a landfill. At first, the police weren't planning to search for the missing man there, as the garbage truck along that route was only estimated to be carrying 33 pounds. Later, however, they discovered the weight was around 220 pounds. The 2.1 million euro investigation has not yet turned up Corey, although authorities believe that the missing man was crushed by a garbage can, and that his passed away body is somewhere in the landfill, and some theories suggest foul play. But regardless, his disappearance remains a mystery. The search for Corey McKeague continues. We all know them, the people of Walmart. But it's not every day you run into one who starts screaming in your face. That's what happened to this man who pulled out his phone to record this man's erratic behavior. YouTuber Bake80 described what happened in his own words. Okay, so I wanted people to see how crazy this guy was. Excuse my language, but this guy was staring and following me in Walmart for about 20 minutes. This is when the uploader decided to record the unfolding event. Pretending to be on his phone, he filmed the man for about a full minute. The man was just standing across the way. Watching Big Sadie just as described, he does appear not to be in his right mind as he turns to someone who isn't there and starts talking. Then the man walks up to Bakes and gets so close, the YouTuber wrote that his hat touched his face. This was why he told him to back off in harsh terms. He wanted the guy to know he was serious. The man responds to this threat by saying he's got all the cop cars in jail. When Bakes stands his ground, the man just starts screaming, "Don't threaten me," in his face repeatedly.
"Don't threaten me!
Walk away.
Don't threaten me! Don't threaten me!"
The people behind him stop dead in their tracks. Even this is too much for the people of Walmart. Then the man hurries away, but you can still hear him shouting, "Don't threaten me," in the background. He's captured again on camera, ranting and raving as he wanders through the checkout aisles, attempting to make his way out. A scary stranger encounter certainly, but also pretty bizarre. A doorbell cam video at 3 a.m. has caught some scary moments on tape that people need to see. Watch this and tell me if you think it's real or fake. A ghostly white apparition forms before the camera half a minute before 3 a.m. It looks pretty good at first, but then it kind of looks less real the longer you look at it. If I saw this phantom-like figure outside of my house at 3 a.m. like the uploader says they did, I would be absolutely terrified. This video of a shaky, alien-looking pod looks like it really shouldn't exist anywhere on planet Earth, let alone some random person's basement. The way it moves from left to right without being touched makes me think that some strange life form is about to burst forth. Most of the comments agree that this could be some sort of egg or cocoon with a foreign host inside. Note how strange furry hair seems to protrude from sections of its hardened exterior, further indicating that this is in fact a living organism of some kind. The video ends before we can see what hatches. But whatever it is, I just hope it isn't something that is harmful. At first, Redditor Dawn Grager believes this sound was in her imagination, but then she recorded it. Listen closely. It sounds like a strangled scream. Some in the comments think it's just air escaping a container of some kind. Others think it's a trapped animal. I wouldn't rule out a portal to the fiery depths below, but those two theories also seem likely. This sound is for sure something you don't want to be imagining. If you've ever been in a bug swarm of any kind, you'll know it can give you chills. This mayfly swarm is no different. In fact, it's practically nightmarish.
Oh my God!
When the mayflies took over this bridge in Iowa, snowplows were required to unblock the swarm buzzing in the bridge's path. In fact, the bridge had been so completely swarmed by the bugs that emergency crews were sent to the area. The nightmare scene turned into a scary situation after bikers tried to plow through the massive heap of mayflies but lost traction. Luckily, they escaped. The bridge's clearing was recorded by Tina Franzen as she rode along in her son's police car. Franzen said of the event, "I've lived in Cibola since 75. I've never seen that many before, ever." To clear the bugs over the following weeks, it was decided by the Iowa Department of Transportation to keep the streetlights off near the bridge as the lights attract the mayflies. Here's hoping it all worked out for Iowa. They don't need any more of this nightmare fuel. When Alexandra went exploring an abandoned schoolhouse in Ukraine, she never expected to go viral.
Что за запах?
Oh, смотри, вон какая штука лежит.
On the first floor is a discarded tracksuit outside of a hole in the floor that looks like it could serve as the final resting place for many.
А вот это было разве?
Нет, это не было открыто. Здесь все было закрыто, здесь ровно пол.
Там какой-то проход дальше, что ли? Ого, он как долго тянется вообще, посмотри.
Да, я вижу.
Он прям уходит вообще.
They also find a green barrel that's full of an unknown chemical. They can't read the faded label, but maybe a subscriber in Russia will know more about this.
Да, вот бочонок. По идее, не знаю, что тут написано, невозможно прочитать сейчас.
It could be acid. I've heard of people dissolving the past away in barrels full of acid, just like this one. Across from a green barrel are footprints, and across from the footprints are pictures of people.
Ладно, пойдем на второй этаж тогда.
Да, ребят.
Это ты?
Есть кто?
Alexandra pauses at the stairs.
Мы с миром пришли, господи. Не надо нас пугать. На приколе, что ли, блядь?
Может, пойдем? Пока.
I think this video is 100% real because Alexandra does this thing some people do when they're really scared, where they talk to themselves out loud to keep from completely breaking down.
Так быстро выходим отсюда, это просто великолепно, потому что я сейчас реально насру себе в штаны и все, на этом все закончится. А вот вон мой великолепный, прекрасный выход, на.
With that said, I'm not sure this video is paranormal. The noise could be someone staying here. A scary person who I'm sure you and I would want nothing to do with. A man who countless others likewise wish they had never seen. A security guard is patrolling the San Francisco College campus when he catches a glimpse of an all-black figure moving fast. He quickly rounds the corner and finds absolutely nothing there. Notice how the silhouette is traveling in a straight line at a high rate of speed and has no time to run up the steps or to hide on the right before the security guard catches up with it. I don't see any jump cut editing either, so I think this could really be an actual ghost. Beyond this fence lays an abandoned asylum that a YouTuber named TGF Bro and his friends badly want to explore. The inside looks like a tattered mansion on the verge of collapse. Strange noises follow them as they progress deeper into the interior of the asylum.
Did you get that on camera?
When they get deep enough, TGF Bro pulls out a Ouija board and begins directing questions to whoever or whatever is near.
If there's anybody there, please move the triangle to yes.
The group hears a loud bang directly behind them, and they all take off. I notice that the third person was off camera though, so maybe that person made the commotion and then acted scared. Then again, old asylums are supposed to be notoriously haunted, so I wouldn't be surprised if the Ouija board really did bring spirits near. Okay, this video is bizarre and just plain really weird. A kid on YouTube named Nature the Bee is making a random video about his cat. Little did he know that he caught a mysterious figure on camera.
And that's the end of the first trailer. I hope you've enjoyed.
Creeping around the house is a strange ghostly apparition. It was not part of the skit he was doing at all and really has no place being there. Plus the way it looks from behind the corner is beyond creepy. You can see some more scary stuff when you zoom in, like a freaky frowning face that the uploader thinks could be a ghost or a demon sighting caught on video. I think this video could be edited, but if not, then I'd say his house is definitely haunted by something paranormal. YouTuber Renoa Super Genius has something random to share. A random secret door hidden in a closet. She says that this door leads to the crawl space under the house, and nice cool air always flows from the crack in the door. Since it's getting a bit hot in the house, and with no airflow, the YouTuber decides to open the crawl space door. not only to cool the room, but to inspect, or mine as she puts it, the underground. After prying the crawl space up with a screwdriver, the YouTuber spans the area with a camera, and viewers see a whole lot of dirt, wires, and the structural foundation of the home. Not an unusual discovery below deck. When she descends down under, the YouTuber finds cables that don't connect to anything. As the exploration underground continues, she finds an old penny from 1951. One YouTuber in the comments, Kiji Hu, notes, "Don't they put pennies in places like this to ward off evil spirits?" In fact, it's true that some superstitious beliefs suggest that copper protects homes from evil spirits and the evil eye. Copper is also believed by some to draw good fortune, which is one possible reason why this YouTuber found a penny beneath the home. While crawl spaces beneath homes are not uncommon, most don't go exploring them, so you can imagine what secrets might be hidden under so many homes across the world. Thank you so much for getting me to 50,000 subscribers here on my Clips channel. If you want to support, please press that subscribe button. Let's get to 60,000 subscribers next. Thank you.